there like a key moment when you felt like, wow, the two worlds meet, the scientific world and the mantra? Was there some kind of like, wow, like a waking up moment in that?
There's been many, many moments, but I think it was, you know, my spiritual teacher was the one who asked me to write this book on the science of mantras. And when she was introducing me to the concept and she was giving me the different bija mantras, and as she was explaining the connection of the bija mantras and just showing me how they connected to make the double helix, and when I looked at her and I said, wait a minute, so mantra, these particular bija mantras are linked to human DNA, and she said, yes, they have the power for changing DNA. I think that, you know, there's two things. To be sitting with your spiritual teacher anyways, you tend to have a level of expansion both of the mind and heart beyond what you typically, you know, the state you're in. But it was in that moment to just see the majesty of the sounds and then the certainty of the biology coming together. Something inside of me really shook, where it was no longer an experience of the auditory system or experience of the mind, but an actual underlying mechanism for the creation of matter. That was a very profound experience for me.
Hmm. So just for those of you who don't know, bija mantras are the short one-syllable mantras that I guess that's what you're talking about, like,
yes.
Prim, yes. Klim, Gam, Hum, Ham, and so on. So,
yes.
So how do you use them? How do you use them when you say you can use them to change DNA?
Well, there's so many different ways of using mantra. The way that I personally grew up using it was, you know, using a bija mantra during meditation. But, you know, just as you're both showing that, there's power to using mantra alone, but there's also power to using mantra in groups and singing or chanting in group or in the form of, you know, devotional worship, that there's a effect both in the individual but also in the groups when they come together. And, you know, these effects we know can be measured, that when groups come together and either chant vocally or silently when they're meditating together, they change the patterns of the brain waves. So, you know, that's kind of the beauty of mantra. It's a private practice as well as a shared spiritual practice.
Cool.
But, you know, I'll be honest with you. My husband and I now have gone, you know, we're like mantra, like hogwild now. We're just mantra crazy. And we will use mantras now for, like, when we're preparing Ayurvedic herbs for our own use, we're chanting mantras. You know, when my husband is cooking dinner, he's chanting mantras. Like, it's really become, like, anything that we are consuming in the body, we will usually just incorporate mantras. And it's not something that was forced. It was just something that we just began to do naturally. Ooh.